Anil, just looking at this Indian team, the players who are currently playing in the 11 and even those who are sitting out, looking at various departments, batting, top order batting, middle order, wicket keeping options, spinners, fast bowlers. Do you sense, also looking at other teams around the world, that we are on the cusp now of watching an Indian team which can dominate over a period of time, home and away?
Yeah, I believe so. Even 3 years ago when I was the coach, I did mention that this team certainly has everything in them to dominate world cricket, and that's exactly what they have done. I mean, it's not just about the playing 11, it's also the bench strength. It's also the quality of bench strength that we are discussing here. You know, you have fantastic quality. Whoever comes in certainly performs. I mean, we saw Nadeem, on his debut test match. He's had a long first-class career. He's played India A on many occasions. He was given the opportunity right at the last minute, and he came in and performed for the team. And that's exactly what you want from your bench strength. And when you have the kind of quality players in the squad, plus people really sitting out and then wanting to make an impact, it really augurs well. And that's why I believe that Indian team is not just good enough to win matches at home, but also abroad, dominate every series outside of India too. So that's something that I would like to see this Indian team do in the future.
Yet again, Anil, just as one of the greats of the game, having played so much yourself, now observing it from a distance, just watching this Indian team do what it did in this series, but overall, looking at how South Africa seemed to capitulate, some of their players not able to take the heat, are you sensing that around the world, Test cricket is in as healthy a space as it should be? Just the Test teams, are enough Test teams competitive enough?
Yeah, it's a bit disappointing when you look around world cricket, South Africa, especially in this recent series and also in the previous series. Of course, the pitches were different. But if you look at the South African team of the past, and when you compare those names to these cricketers, it certainly is disappointing at the quality that you saw. Faf du Plessis was the only seasoned performer for South Africa, and he was batting at number 5. By which time, most of the damage was done. So, yes, it was disappointing. Other than Rabada and Faf du Plessis, and in the first test, Dean Elgar and Quinton de Kock. Other than these four, the rest of the team just looked pretty ordinary. You don't expect that coming from a South African team. So, yes, when you look at South Africa, West Indies, Australia, when India toured Australia, of course, they missed David Warner and Steve Smith, but when you look at that, of the past era, you tend to think that yes, in terms of Test cricket, you would want to see more teams really doing really well consistently. It's not easy winning away from home. We have seen that even for the current Indian team, other than the Australian series, they couldn't win in England and in South Africa. So teams, find it difficult when they tour. But having said that, they at least put up a fight. South Africa, we have seen of the past, they have won the series in India in 99-2000. And then rest of the time that South Africa toured India, they've certainly fought hard. You didn't see that fight anywhere close to that fight in the South African team. So that way, yes, it is certainly disappointing to see a South African team, having capitulated the way they did against India.